Good evening, fellow conspirators. It's a radical idea that we can achieve peace in our lifetime. That's a very un-American idea. As unfortunately, our nation has evolved over the last 250-some-odd years. Starting with the first incursions of Europeans to our shores, we began genocide, eradicating the Native American people. And we continued with the black-skinned people from Africa through slavery. And we continued all throughout our march to the California coast. And in 1961, the military-industrial congressional complex, that was in the original language of President Eisenhower's speech, and his advisors told him he could not accuse a fellow separate but equal branch of government of being part of that complex, so he scratched it out, but it's in the history. That complex is as alive and sick today as it ever was. So that ending the war in Iraq is not enough. And the war of my generation in Vietnam, it took us 12 years, but the peace movement, very much at the end, with all of the GI resistance, when the army would no longer fight the war that the generals and the politicians wanted, the war ended after 12 years. We're 5 years, and the casualties are mounting. And this time, we have to mobilize, start an insurgency if we have to, a new American revolution if we have to. And some concrete things I'm going to give you just two, because I'm sure my 2 minutes gone. Check your stock portfolios, please, any of you that have stocks. To include your retirement benefits and demand or sell off any stocks that you own or that your retirement funds own of the war industry. Let's call it, it's not a war industry. That's too nice a word. It's a genocide industry. Stop and war is not humane. Second, the concrete thing I would suggest is that if any of you are veterans, veterans of conscience, not like most veterans unhappily in our country are, who because of their traumas often, if they were in combat, have to wrap themselves around the flag to justify the terror and the horror that they experienced in their war. I have some noble laws, meaning, if any of you are veterans, please join with Peter and myself and other veterans for peace. There's 24.5 million veterans in the United States. Maybe at the most 10,000 are members of Veterans for Peace, Vietnam Veterans Against the War, and the new cohort, the Iraq Veterans Against the War. That shows how strong our military culture is. And the last thing, I'm just going to end with a quote from Thomas Jefferson, the primary author of our Declaration of Independence from the tyranny of the British Crown. This quote is from 1785, when he spoke out against another evil in our society that we overcame, slavery. And this quote is especially apt in these times of xenophobia and Christian fascist genocidal crusade against the civilians in the Muslim world, as well as anyone else that they deem not saved. Here's the quote. Indeed, I tremble when I reflect that God is just. Thank you.